The date is August 21st, 2020. Friday. Not that much music came out last night. Not that much music that I was crazy about. Not things that people would want to see reactions to. You know, like the new Bright Eyes album. I don't think people want to see a reaction to a Bright Eyes album. But today we've got the new Troye Sivan EP. 19-minute runtime, 6 songs. It's called In a Dream. And I think there was 2 singles from it. And I think I heard a little bit of Rager Teenager. I can't remember if I heard Easy or not, but I think Easy got like some radio play or something. So I don't remember, but we'll see. Man, I used to be a big Troye Sivan fan in like middle school in 2015 when Blue Neighborhood came out, and just like every song on there was my shit when I was really emo. Cause I was into him when he was a YouTuber too, when I was in like 5th grade. But yeah, I haven't paid too much attention to his music since Blue Neighborhood. But for some reason now, I'm curious about what this is about. I thought it was a good opportunity to kind of switch up genres a little bit on this channel. I guess this is probably classified as pop, right? And I usually do hip hop. Let me not do any more talking. Let's get into this shit. First track is Take Yourself Home. Also, I got these new speakers that should make it sound a little better. It's time to go. Take nice. Yourself home. Talk to me. There's nothing that can't be fixed with some honesty. Oh! And how we got this dark is just beyond to me. Bro, his vocals have improved a lot. Is that just me? I don't think I always thought they were the craziest vocals ever, but this just sounds super in tune and everything, and that little subtle ass percussion. It's right there where you lost it when you took the best. Oh! I'm sorry. It must seem like I'm overhyping it right now, but literally, I just, when there's a nice chord progression like that. You know what I'm saying? That's like, I've probably heard that before in a pop song, but those kinds of pop progressions are just so addicting, you know what I mean? So it doesn't get old for me. Counting all the losses that you can collect, got everything and nothing in my life. And these lyrics are not bad at all. They're really talking about something. Who is on his production team? I'm gonna look at the song show credits. Who produced this? Oscar Gores. Wow. Whoa. Do you hear all the details in that production, man? It's really trying to create this whole, and effectively so, creating this whole atmosphere that us teens chase after, this nostalgic, you know, it's the kind of music that's gonna be nostalgic when we're older, you know what I'm saying? Like, I think about music when I hear something like that. I think about that when I hear music like that. Like, I don't know if that's just me, but like, there's certain songs that I just know are gonna be hella nostalgic when I'm older, because they just have this such a distinct, you know, teenage vibe. Sorry for lack of a better word. And Troye Sivan, that's definitely, that's the kind of music I understand. As far as I understand, that's the music that he's trying to make, is like teenage, late night, head out the sunroof, you know, smoking. That's how I think about it. Oh. The ending was interesting. I'm gonna have to listen to that whole song a few more times. To me, that ending felt a little sudden and like it just like switched into dubstep like really fast. And I do, there are certain songs I know that do that that I definitely enjoy. But it felt like it just kind of like a totally opposite feeling than what the rest of the song was giving. But it might just take some getting used to. It's kind of what I might, is what I'm predicting. But nonetheless, that was actually a fantastic intro. On to Easy. I know this came out, I don't think I've heard this. Something to say, I went straight to make it okay. And he made it easy, darling. Wow, that is soaked in a reverb. Wow. Sorry, that's just like a lot of reverb. What's left of the dance, the sun on my head, the rock in my throat, a hair on my coat, the street. I like the way the second verse came in. Just his voice sounds really clear. As opposed to that abundance of reverb a minute ago, this just, his voice just now cut through really clear and it really struck a chord. Yeah, honestly, I wish all that reverb wasn't there. I wish it was much more. I don't know how to put it, but I just wish that much reverb wasn't there, honestly. I don't know what instrument that is, but wow. So it's some sort of synthesized instrument. Tune for a second there? That's interesting. I just got Frank Ocean Blonde vibes from this outro right here. And the album turned 4 yesterday. The sort of ambience there. Again, a track I'm gonna have to play back a few times. And I also think that this is gonna be a grower. But I don't mind it one bit off of first listen. This is definitely creating the atmosphere I was talking about before. The next song is called Could Cry Just Thinking About You, and it looks like it's an interlude, just 52 seconds long. Beginning sounded like Endless by Frank Ocean, which came out on August 19th, 2016. So that also just turned 4. Interesting. Also a chord progression that I feel like I've heard before, and it's sort of a folksy chord progression. It reminds me of some of the folk songs and bluegrass songs in North Carolina that I grew up on. I like it. It sounds like home. That it was that short. That really sucks that it was that short. That's nice. Okay, well, the next song is called Stud. Was that a cassette sound that I just made? Edgy. Retro. Sorry, not to make fun of him. I don't think it's just funny when people do that. It's time, you can come. That little, that synth right there. You can come and meet me out front. You got all the muscles and the features I want. Right, so, and Troye just, he just really captures, like, the feeling of, like, young love, and it feels legitimate since he's young as hell. When he was first really popular on YouTube, he was, like, 18, 19 or something like that, maybe younger, 16, when he, like, first got attention, and he still looks like a teenager, but he's, like, 20-something now, but, yeah, he captured that feeling of young love really well. Suburban love story, it feels like. Oh, that's probably Troye Sivan's type, is like a stud. He said, what's it like to be strong and buff? Troy's all skinny and small. So I assume maybe the song is about his type that he looks for in a man. Searching for something I'm not. Nice. Knowing that you're not the world. It's weird. The production is like kind of just like kind of going in and out, and it's like it's kind of swirling a little bit, and it's very it's like uneven, but in like an aesthetically pleasing way. Did he say, how much of me would you change on second thought? Don't say a thing. That's. I wish that clap wasn't there. Or at least a different sounding clap. This is sounding a little too dubsteppy. Some dubstep is bearable, but it's kind of, you know. Okay, I was worried it would do that. Not bad, not terrible. But I'm just not crazy about those, these sorts of dance breakdowns that sound like this. Just. Ugh! That's nice though. Turn that up. Hey. We're into this fight. We should do this fight. Oh! That sounds good! We should do this fight. You can make my fight. We should do this fight. Red face over here, y'all see it. Oh my god, it happens so easily. My goodness. Next track is Rage Your Teenager. I believe I've heard it once, but I don't think I really remember it. But I think it came out kind of relatively recently, but. Is that clear? Is that clear that bad? Hopefully it's okay. Wasting time, never thought I'd see you again in my life. Why you been acting like a stranger? Feeling alive, a teenager. Ooh, feels kind of cool in the rager. And I never thought I'd see the day of my life. I don't really remember this. I just wanna go wild. I just wanna fuck shit up and just ride in your car tonight. In your bed tonight. I just wanna sing loud. Teenager, trying to figure. That glare is kind of bad, but I think it looks the video look kind of cool. Wow. Very unique drum sounds and unique pattern. I love when drums are like not your average drums, when they sound odd. They're like, they're distorted like that. Yeah, so this is like the epitome of like Troye Sivan's music to me. The song title and everything, you know, it's a hard, and you know, I admire him for it, because it's kind of a hard feeling to articulate, the feeling that he's articulating, like the, I mean, I was already going on about it, but the teenage, all the teenage shit. I don't mind this one, but I like this so far. I don't think I was really expecting to like this one, because I think I remember not liking it when I first heard it, but I think I only heard a little bit of it when I first heard it, because I don't really remember this at all. Like, it's so grand. It's definitely not the sort of, I guess you wouldn't really call this sound lo-fi, at least his older music, but it's just, he's grown a lot since 2015. But now most of the glare is gone. That's a cool sound. That was a sick outro. Next song is In a Dream. Last song. Sixth song. Title track. In a Dream. Not a good dancer. Never said I was a good dancer. Oh. Right there, that sounded like a Charlie XCX song. I've said before, I love Charlie XCX. So it sounds really happy, but there's a tinge of despair in there. So I don't have the lyrics up. I've been more listening to the sounds going on. I can't tell if this is supposed to be a happy or sad song, but no, I mean, I guess songs aren't supposed to be either happy or sad. That's not what I mean. It's not black and white like that, but you know there are a lot of songs like that are like, have a strange mix of both, but generally it's nice when it's a mix of both. It's kind of difficult to mix the two, I think, sometimes, so again, commendable. Once again, they like switching the often they like switching the mixing on the vocals to very atmospheric and reverb soaked to very clear cut and right in your ear, and I think that's an interesting contrast to do. I think it adds texture to the song, and yeah, I like that. Love the chorus. Definitely love the chorus. Oops. I definitely like that for a closer. it sounds like it could be a big song. I hope it is. He deserves all the blessings and streams that come his way. Super enjoyable EP, man. In a Dream. Really fits the cover, too. I'll put the cover right here. Just the feeling that the cover gives you is the same feeling the music gives you. I think that's the goal that an album cover should have, is to do that. Or EP cover. Again, all I can really say is he's just really mastered that. I've said it like 20 times, but the whole debacle of teenagerism, he has mastered the capturing of that feeling, of feeling young and wild and free and, I don't know, drunk and high and in love. And it figures that this kind of music gets so big. I know a lot of people love Troye Sivan. He's, you know, he worked with Ariana Grande and stuff, so he's definitely gotten pretty huge since then, at least. But, you know, it's so relatable. Is the thing about it, or maybe not relatable, but it's like he's singing about the sort of life that we want, sort of as teenagers. Just dumb kids, and we want to be drunk and high and in love, and like I was saying before, riding through in the nighttime, head out of the sunroof with your high school sweetheart. That's what this feels like, man. You know, some musicians tackle that. A lot of like bedroom pop tackles that. Tries to capture that sort of feeling, and often do, but it might come off sort of corny in a way, or just artificial. But this is definitely seems genuine, and it's evocative and like I already said again, nostalgic feeling, and I like it a lot, man. I didn't really have any expectations, I guess, but maybe sort of subconscious ones. I think maybe a couple times Troye has gotten a little deep, too deep into his like pop, like pure made for the radio bag. And that's not always the most attractive kind of music when it's like obviously just so curated for radio. And you know, a couple of these, I mean, when he does those like in these couple songs where he does those like dance breakdown type of things, I could do without those. Usually those sound like they're catered for radio a little bit. I mean, I'm not really saying that there's anything wrong with catering things to radio, but like, I don't know, there's just something, just a smidge unsettling about it when it's just so blatant. But, this did feel very authentic to me, and personal. And real, yeah. Real is synonymous with genuine, but yeah, I'll shut up there. Hopefully people looking for some Troye Sivan reaction, for a Troye Sivan reaction, found this channel and are watching this, and if you're watching till the end, thank you so much. And I hope no Troye Sivan fans get too mad at me about anything I said. I know he definitely has a strong fan base. But with that, it's been Robbie the Reactor. I'll probably see you around next Friday if that Drake album is coming out. And a couple other things that I think I'm gonna check out. Much love to you all. Once again, thanks for tuning in, and see you soon.